If I'm going to start with the Python, this is a simple command that I can write over here, like print, hi, good morning. This is your simple Python program, and we are getting the output. You don't need to use any hash include and all. You don't need to use any import and all. You don't need to use the public static void main. It's a simple line that I'm going to write over there. It's print, hi, good morning, and we are getting the output. Sorry. Suppose I'm writing a is equal to 20. I'm writing b is equal to 30. I'm writing c is equal to a plus b. And I'm just going to give print c, and we are getting the output. This is how you need to write the Python code. And when we write the code over here, this is called immediate mode. This is called immediate mode. Other than the immediate mode, we are having the skip mode. A skip mode means what? You need to open the file. You need to open the file, new file. And this is the window, like notepad window. But exactly, it's not a notepad. See, a lot of things are there. It's different from the notepad. But what we can do, we can write the code over here. So I'm just going to write the code. This is the first program I'm going to use, has. This is the comment line in the Python. I'm just going to write first program in Python. What I need to do? So this is what, this is your skip mode. So we can write the code over here. This is your immediate mode. And we can open the file and we can write the code over here. This is your skip mode. So now what I need to do, I need to write the program. I'm looking for some input. So for the input, what I need to do, I am writing nm is equal to, I am writing input, enter name. Now I need to display this name. I am writing print nm. So input is basically for the user input. Like in C, we are having the scanf. The same thing, we are having input over there. To display what we need to use, just we need to use the print over there. And now we need to run this program. To run the program, what we need to do, just we need to click on this run. The run module is there. I'm just going to click on this run module. Or we can press the F5. If I'm going to press the F5, source must be saved. So I need to save this file. So I'm just going to save this file. And by default, my file is going to save in this location. We can save this file in any location, whether it's in C drive or in drive, E drive. I can store this file in any location. But right now, I'm just going to save over here. I'm going to give the name of the file. Suppose I'm going to give like test1.py. Py is the extension of your file. It's a Python file. So I'm just writing test1.py. Save this file. Now, it's running, asking for the input. I'm just going to give enter name. I'm just going to give like Santosh. And we are getting the output Santosh over there. Again, we are coming in this file. Suppose I want to display the value like this. The name age. Again, run this. Enter name. Suppose Smith I'm going to give. And we are getting the name is Smith. So this is basically for the input. And this is for the output. Suppose I need to enter the number. How we can do this? I'm writing n is equal to input. I'm giving enter number. Again, I need to enter the value. Remember, when we apply the input command, by default, it enter the data type will be a string. So I need to convert a string into the integer. So I'm just writing int. Again, I am writing m is equal to int. Input. I'm writing enter number. Sum is equal to n plus m. We are writing print. The sum is comma sum. If I'm going to run this, this is the name I'm going to give. The name is Santosh. Now I'm going to enter the number. And we are getting the sum is 110. So this is how you can write the program. We don't need to use any semicolon over there. It's not required. Unnecessary spaces and all that we need to avoid. Suppose what I need to do, so this is how we can go for the input. This is how we can go for the input. Now what I need to do, I want to apply the if statement. How we can do this? That we need to take care. Suppose I am writing if sum greater than 100, then now we need to use the colon. See, this is the cursor position. Always I need to write from this position only, that's it. After the colon, I am just using enter over there. Now this is the cursor location. Always I need to write in this location only, that's it. I'm just going to give like print, hi, number is greater than 100. Now what I need to do? I need to use the else portion over there. So else will be the part of if. Sorry, I'm just using else. And again, after the else, we need to use the colon. So this colon is basically, you can say it's the start of the body. Now I need to write from here, like print, hi, number is less than 100. That's it. This is your if statement. Run this, enter name, enter number, and we are getting hi, number is less than 100. The sum is 99, it's less than 100. So this is how we can apply the if statement over there. Suppose I need to apply the for loop. I'm just going to use the for loop over there. How we can do this? For I in, you don't need to declare the variables. You don't need to use the semicolon. You don't need to use the braces. Only this colon you need to remember always. Suppose I'm using for I in, I'm using range. Range is the function. I need to execute the loop from 1 to 10. I'm just going to use 1 to 5. I'm just going to use 1, 6. So by default, it will start from the 1 up to 5. And I'm just going to give print I. We are getting the value. We are getting the value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is how we can apply the range over there in the for loop. And again, suppose I'm just going to use print over there. And we are getting the message expected an indentation block. This message means what? The space is not correct. I'm just going to give tab. No, it's fine. I'm just going to give tab. No, it's fine. So that we need to take care. And the basic fundamental we need to follow is after column, what will be the position? In that position, we need to write the thing, write the command. Suppose I want to apply the while loop. While c less than equal to 5, colon, c is equal to c plus 1, print c. And I need to declare the c all over there, like I'm going to use c is equal to 0. Run this. Now we are getting the value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And again we are getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 by the use of while loop. So this is how we can use the while loop. You don't need to use the braces. This is how you can use the for loop. This is how we can use the if statement. This is how you can input the number. This is how you can display the number. This is how you can input the string. So these are the basic fundamental. Okay. So this is your test1.py. Now what I'm going to do. How to start the Python? What we need to write? IDLE, Integrated Development Environment. Just I'm going to talk about like Python data type. When we are talking about the Python data type, in the Python, the first thing is we are having Python number. We are having Python numbers. In the number, the first one is integer type. The first one is integer type. The second one is floating point number. And the third one is the complex number.
So can you please increase the size of your...
Yeah, sure. Yeah, I'm going to do that. Configure ideally. And you just need to increase the size over there. And that's fine now. Yeah, it's fine. This is how you can do this. Option, configure ideally. This is the font, this is the size, this is how you can apply the bold. So this is you can apply. So if I'm talking about the Python data type, the first thing is the integer, the second thing is the floating point number, and the third one is the complex number. For the integer, it's defined as int. For the float, it's defined as the float. And for the complex, it's defined as complex. If I'm going to use n is equal to, remember, in Python, you don't need to declare the data type. According to the data, it will automatically assign that particular data type. Suppose I'm going to give, if I'm going to write print type of n, and we are getting it's an integer type. Suppose I'm using n is equal to like this, and I'm going to use print type of n. By default, it's a float type. By default, it's a float type. Suppose I'm using n is equal to 1 plus 2j print n. By default, it's a complex number. Print type of n. It's a complex number. So we are having the integer, we are having the float, and we are having the complex number. It's by default over there. One important thing is there, like in every language, there is some limitation with the length and all. As such in Python, we don't have any limitation. Integer can be of any length. Remember, like I'm using n is equal to, and I am giving this value, print type of n. Yeah, it's an integer type. So as such in Python, we don't need to bother about the limitation, the size and all. Suppose I'm using f is equal to 3. Printf. Now remember, for the floating point, it allows up to 15 decimal places. Officially, it's up to 15 decimal places. After the decimal, you can go for the 15 decimal places. 15 decimal places, it's a use.
That's the limit, sir, or
there's... See, as such, you can go up to, you can go up to 50, but accuracy is up to 15 decimal places. Mm-hmm. Okay. After this number, so the first thing is in the data type, we are having the Python number. In the number, we are having the integer number, we are having the floating point number, and we are having the complex number. Other than this integer, this numeric data type, the next thing what we are having, it's an important one that is called Python list. What exactly the list is? List is an ordered sequence of item. This is the most used data type in the Python. And remember, it's generic. It's generic and dynamic. Generic means what? You can put any values over there. And dynamic means what? You can give any number of values over there. And one important thing like to define the list, always we need to use this bracket over there. This is the symbol that it's a list. So list is what? It's an order sequence of item. It's a generic. And again, it's a dynamic. And this is the symbol of defining the list. This bracket we need to use. Like I'm going to use A is equal to, and I'm going to use 22, 33, 44, just like array. I'm going to give Santosh. I'm just going to give the number. Again, I'm going to give the string. I'm going to give the number. Yeah, it's perfectly fine. If I'm going to write print type of A, it belongs to the list type. It belongs to the list type. If I'm going to give like print A, these are the value we are having in the list. Suppose I'm going to give print A of 0. Yeah, it's going to give me 22 because it's a start from the 22. Remember, list always start from the 0. List always get a start from the 0. Now, suppose I'm going to give like print A of 0 colon 3. What we are getting? From the 0 position, the 3 character. From the 0 position, this is the 0 position. How many characters we are talking about? It's 3. So we are getting these 3 value. Suppose we are writing print A of 3 colon 0, 1, 2, 3. So from the 3 onwards, each and everything. From the 3 onwards, we are getting everything. Suppose I am using print A of colon 3. Up to 3, you will get everything. So this is how you can get the value from the list. That is the good thing. The highest level of flexibility is there. We can also apply the for loop over there, like I'm going to use for I in A. And I'm just going to use print I. And we are getting the value. We are getting the value one by one. So this is how we can apply the for loop. This is how we can access the values. This is how we can access the values. Even you can also apply the negative indexing over there. We can also apply the negative indexing. Negative indexing means what? This is the list. This is your minus 1, this is your minus 2, this is your minus 3. So just I'm going to give like print A of minus 1. What will be the output? I'm just going to give A of minus 1. What will be the output? Minus 1, it's from the last. The value you will get, 666. Yeah, we are getting this. So this is what, this is your list. Remember one important thing, that list is mutable. Mutable means what? We can make changes. We can make changes. Like I am using A of 0 is equal to ln Smith. So I'm just going to give A of 0 is equal to ln Smith. Now I'm writing print A, and we are getting, earlier it was 22. Now in the place of 22, we are having ln Smith. So this is what, the list is mutable. So this is the thing that we need to remember about the list. So list is what? It's an order sequence of item. Order sequence of item means what? You are just entering the data. In the same sequence, every time you will get the data. So it maintains the order. Yeah, it's a generic. Generic means what? You can put any values. We are giving the integer. We are giving the string. We are giving the float value, decimal values over there. And dynamic. Dynamic means what? Any number of values you can put over there. You can give any number of values over there. So this is what? This is the example of list. And the important thing that we need to consider is, list is mutable. We can make changes with the list. One important thing that we need to remember is list index start from the zero. List index start from the zero. So this is what, this is your list. After the list.
Sir.
Yeah, please.
Can you explain again why the print A inside the bracket negative 1 became 666?
Yeah. Basically, it's a, let's see. In the list, yeah. This one is what? This is index 0. This is index 1. This is 2. Okay. This is 3. This is 4. This is 5. This is 6. Mm-hmm. But okay. If I will start the negative indexing, mm-hmm. negative indexing means what? From the back side, it will be minus 1. It will be minus 2. It will be minus 3.
Oh.
It will be minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7.
Wow, it's different. Okay.
Yeah, so this is what, this is the negative indexing.
Thank you.
Index from the back side. Okay. Now the next thing is, after the list, the next important thing we are having is Python tuple. See, the Python tuple is same as list. Everything is same. But one difference is there. Your tuple is immutable. Immutable means what? You cannot make the changes with the tuple. And the second thing that we need to consider is, for the tuple, always we need to use this parenthesis. Like in the list, we have to use this parenthesis over there. In the tuple, we need to use this parenthesis. Suppose I'm going to use n is equal to, and I'm going to give print n. If I'm writing print type of n, what we are getting? It's a tuple. Again, we can apply like print n of 0. We are getting 11. Suppose we are writing print, if I'm going to write print n of minus 1, negative indexing, we are getting 22, the last value. Suppose we are using print n of 2:5. We are getting 33, 44 and SSS. From the second position, this is the second position up to the 5. So this is the third, fourth, fifth. We are getting all these three. Everything is same. We can also apply the for loop over there for I in n. And I am writing print I. Everything is same. But the difference is, like if I'm going to give n of 0 is equal to, I'm going to give ln border. What we are getting? We are getting the message can't assign to function call. Why? Because you are using the tuple, and the tuple you can't make the changes. In the tuple you can't make the changes. That changes is allowed with the list. So that is the difference between list and tuple. It's clear? Any questions from your side? Everything is, it's clear now?
Yeah, it's clear.
Okay. So initially it was the list. For the list, what we need to use? We just need to use this bracket. After that, the next thing is the tuple. For the tuple, always we need to use this parenthesis. The difference between list and tuple is immutable. We can't make the changes over there. Now, the next thing we are having is Python string. Again, a string is what? It's a sequence of character. And for the string, we can use the single quotation. We can use the single quotation or we can use the double quotation. We can use the single quotation or we can use the double quotation. We can also this triple single quotation, and we can also use this. Remember, a string index will start, again, the index will start from 0. Index will start from the 0. What we can say, like list, everything is fine. But it's again non-mutable. Suppose I'm going to use nm is equal to, I'm just going to give like Santosh from India. This is the string we are having. Now I'm going to use print nm of 0. What we are getting? S. Suppose I'm writing print nm of 1. What we are getting? It's A. Suppose I'm writing print nm of 0 comma 5. Yeah. Suppose I'm going to write print nm of minus 1. What we are getting? A. The last one. Suppose I'm writing print nm of colon 3. So this is how we can use the list. Suppose I'm writing nm of 0 is equal to z. Now we are getting the error. Why we are getting the error? Because it's a non-mutable. Non-mutable means what? You can't make the changes over there. That's the string. So a string and tuple both are non-mutable. That you need to remember. We can also apply the for loop over there. For I in, a string is nm, and I'm just going to give print I, and we are getting the output. Yeah, we are getting Santosh from India. Suppose I'm going to use, we can also use the string like this, nm is equal to, even we can apply the single quotation. Thanks. We can apply the single quotation, print nm of 0. Yeah, perfectly fine. We can also use like this, nm is equal to, print nm of 0 comma 5. Yeah, we are getting this. So this is how we can use the string. More or less, the string is just like your list and all. Just we need to consider like double quotation or single quotation that we can use over there. After the list, so the first was the list, the next was the tuple, now we are having the string, the next is we are having the set. Set is there. We are having the set. What exactly the set is? Remember, set is an ordered collection of unique item. Collection of unique items. Set is what? It's an unordered collection of unique item. Unordered collection means what? It's not going to maintain the order. And again the unique item. And for the set, what we can do, we just need to use this braces over there. For the set, we just need to use the braces over there. Suppose I'm going to use nm is equal to. if I'm writing print type of NM. The type is set. Suppose I'm writing print NM. See what is the result. We are getting the results like this. That's why the definition is set is what? It's unordered collection of unique item. As such, we don't have any duplicate values. That's the good thing about the set. It will not contain the duplicate value. But again, the important thing is it's unordered collection. Unordered collection means what? It will not maintain the order. That's basically the set that you need to remember. Suppose I'm going to give NM of 0. I'm going to give print NM of 0. Remember, like list, like set, like a list, like tuple, like a string, we cannot apply the indexing over there. That again we need to remember. Suppose I'm going to use for I in NM. And I'm going to print I. Yeah, we are getting this value. Suppose I'm going to make some changes over there. NM of 0 is equal to T. We can't do that. So in the shortcut, what we can say, like your tuple, like your string, like your set, all are immutable. Only the list is immutable. You can make changes with the list. Remember, in the list, in the tuple, in the string, can use the indexes over there. It's not allowed in set. Advantage of set is unique collection of item. Duplicate is not allowed over there. For the list, what parenthesis we need to use? This one. For the set, what we need to use? Sorry. For the tuple, what we need to use? This one. And for the set, what we need to use? This braces. That we need to take care. After the list, tuple, set, and string, now we are having the next thing is there. It's Python dictionary. It's an unordered collection of key value pair. This is how we can define the, like I'm using M is equal to, and I'm using name Santos. And I'm just going to give like subject Python. If I'm going to use printm, so this name is what? It's a key and this is the value. Subject is what? It's a key and this is the value. Suppose I'm going to use print type of m. It's a dictionary type. Suppose I'm going to use print m of name. We are getting the values. So by the use of key, even you can get the values with this. So this is what? dictionary that we need to maintain. Now, what was the data type? Initially, it was the number data type, numeric. In the numeric, what types was there? Like integer was there, float was there, and the complex number was there. After this numeric, now the next we are having the list. We are having the tuple. We are having the string. We are having the set. And we are having the dictionary. Now, the next thing what we are going for, conversion between data type. Conversion between data type. How we can go for the conversion? Like what we are having, suppose I am writing n is equal to 89. If I am going to print type of n, we are getting this one. We are getting this one. If I am going to use print float of n, I am going to convert the integer into the float. See, now we are getting 89.0. Suppose we are having 45.67. It's a float value. I want to get only the integer. I am writing int of n. We are getting the integer value. So this is how we can convert the things. And one important thing, like see, we are having the list. I'm going to define the list over there. This is the list we are having. I can convert the list into the set. Suppose my question is, we are having some values in the list and I need to remove the duplicate values from the list. My question is, this is the list we are having. In the list, we are having the duplicate values. Now what I need to do, I just need to remove the duplicate values from the list. So how we can do that? Just we are writing set of m. Yeah, it's get converted automatically. We don't need to do anything over that. We can also use like print, I'm using tuple of m. We are getting the values in the tuple. So this is how we can convert the data type. And this is the good thing. I really like this. Like this is the list. I need to remove the duplicate values, nothing to do. Just convert the list into the set. And you will get the unique collection of unique values over there. So this is how we can apply the conversion. This is how we can apply the conversion over there. Now, after this, the next thing that we need to consider is after conversion of data type, the next thing that we need to consider is its input, its output, and import. See, for the input, we are having the input function. We are having the input function. That's not a problem. And for the output, what we are having the print function. We are having the print function. Now, with the print function, we just need to consider the format over there. With the print function, what we need to do, we just need to apply the format over there. So how we can apply the formatting with the print? See, suppose this is the value we are having. I am writing a is equal to 20, b is equal to 30. I am just going to use print. I am just going to use print over there. And I am writing the value of x is braces and y is braces. Now we are using dot format. So with the print, we can apply dot format. In the format, we are just passing x, y. X will get placed over here and y will get placed over here. This is just like your percentage D in C. Oh. what we are having is A and B. So just we need to write the value of A is this one, and the value of B is like this one. I'm using format A comma B. So this is how we can apply the formatting over there. The value of A is 20 and the value of B is 30. We can also use, like I'm using, print the value of A is, suppose here I am writing the value of A is 1 and B is 0. So this will be what? This will be your 0 and this will be 1. We are getting the value of A is 30. Why we are getting 30? Because B, the value of B is 30. Why we are getting like B is 0? Why we are getting 0 means what? We are talking about the A and the value of A is 20. That's why we are getting 30 and 20. So we can apply the format over there. We can apply the format over there. We can also apply the format like this. Suppose I am writing print hi name comma, suppose I am using greetings, dot, I am using format. In the format, what we are using? We are using name is equal to Santosh, comma, I am giving like greetings is equal to. So this is how we can pass the named argument also over there. Greetings is equal to good morning. Dot format name and all, one parenthesis again required. Yeah, hi Santosh, good morning. The name, this value is coming from there. The greetings, this value is coming from there. So this is how we can use this. Even we can also use like a percentile tag over there. Like we can use the percentile tag over there. Suppose we are writing x is equal to 12.3456789. Now what I'm writing? I'm writing print the value of x is percentile 3.2f comma percentile, I'm using percentile x. See what we are getting. The value of x is 12.35, because after decimal we are just along two characters over there, 35. Suppose we are using the value of x is 3.4. So after the decimal it's allowed the four characters over there. So this is how we can use this. Suppose we are using for the input, we don't need to do anything. Like I'm using n is equal to input, enter number. I'm just going to use println. Yeah, it's fine. Suppose I'm going to use, there is the function called eval. I'm going to use eval 2 plus 3 and we are getting 5. Even though this is in a string, we are using the single quotation, means it's a string, but by the use of eval function we can convert this string into the number. So eval function is there that we can apply.